Good morning, friends. Let me welcome you to my channel, TK Bansal. We were working out our problems from JEE Main 2019 Physics, 11th of January 2019 morning session. Before going further, please press the subscribe button and don't forget to press the bell icon to receive the notification of all my future videos. Our next question is, two equal resistances when connected in series to a battery consume an electric power of 60 watt. If these resistances are connected in parallel combination to the same battery, the electric power consumed will be. Our choices are 50 watts, 240 watts, 30 watts, 120 watts. Obviously, this is a very simple question from current electricity and can be done verbally. Let us now solve our question. Let capital R represents each of the two resistors and capital V represents the EMF of the battery. Case 1, when the two resistors are connected in series, their effective resistance is 2R and the power consumed is given by P equals V square divided by 2R, which is given to be 60 watts. Equation 1. Case 2, when the two resistors are connected in parallel, the effective resistance of the combination will be R dash equals R divided by 2 and the power consumed P dash is given by P dash equals twice of capital V square divided by R, or P dash equals 4 times of V square divided by 2R. Since V square by 2R is equal to 60 watts, therefore P dash equals 4 into 60 is equal to 240 watts. Our answer matches with option 2, and hence option 2 is the right answer. Go to our next question. Our question is, a gas mixture consists of 3 moles of oxygen and 5 moles of argon at a temperature of capital T. Consider only translational and rotational modes. The total internal energy of the system is. Our options are 12 RT, 15 RT, 20 RT and 4 RT. This is a very simple question from thermodynamics. Let us now solve this question. We know that the internal energy of n moles of an ideal gas at a temperature of capital T is given by U equals n into F by 2 R T, where F is the degrees of freedom and R is the universal gas constant. In this problem, the gas is a mixture of oxygen and argon. So, we have to add internal energy of each of the two components separately. Given number of moles of oxygen equals 3 and the number of degrees of freedom of oxygen being a diatomic gas equals 5. Likewise, number of moles of argon equals 5 and degrees of freedom of argon being a monatomic gas equals 3. Therefore, U equals 3 into 5 by 2 RT plus 5 into 3 by 2 RT, which becomes 15 RT. So, our answer matches with option 2. Therefore, option 2 is the right answer. Go to our next question. An amplitude modulated signal is given by V as a function of T equals 10 square bracket starts 1 plus 0.3 cos 2.2 into 10 to the power 4 T round bracket closed square bracket closed into sine of 5.5 into 10 to the power 5 T. Here T is in seconds. The side band frequencies in kilohertz are given pi equals 22 divided by 7. Our choices are 1785 and 1,178.5 and 171.5, 89.25 and 85.75 and 892.5 and 857.5. Now it's a very simple question from communication systems and is based on amplitude modulation. Let's solve this question. From the given equation, Vt equals 10 into 1 plus 0.3 cos 2.2 into 10 to the power 4 t bracket closed into sine of 5.5 into 10 to the power 5 t. It is clear that the carrier frequency omega c equals 5.5 into 10 raised to power 5 radians per second and modulating frequency omega m equals 2.2 into 10 raised to power 4 radians per second. Let omega u and omega l represent the upper and the lower side bands respectively. Then omega u equals 5.5 into 10 to the power 5 plus 2.2 into 10 to the power 4, or omega u equals 55 plus 2.2 into 10 to the power 4 radians per second, which equals 57.2 into 10 to the power 4 radians per second. Likewise, omega l equals 5.5 into 10 to the power 5 minus 2.2 into 10 raised to power 4 radians per second. Omega L equals 55 minus 2.2 into 10 raised to power 4, which equals 52.8 into 10 raised to power 4 radians per second. From here, it is clear that Fu equals 572 divided by 2 pi kilohertz, which equals 91 kilohertz. Likewise, FL equals 528 divided by 2 pi kilohertz, which simplifies to give me 84 kilohertz. Although the calculated values do not match with either of the four choices given in the problem, but these values are closest to option 3, and hence option 3 may be taken as the right choice. Go to our next question. Ice at minus 20 degrees Celsius is added to 50 grams of water at 40 degrees Celsius. When the temperature of the mixture reaches 0 degrees Celsius, it is found that 20 grams of ice is still unmelted. The amount of ice added to water was close to. Specific heat of water is 4.2 joules per gram degree Celsius. Specific heat of ice is 2.1 joules per gram degree Celsius. And heat of fusion of water at 0 degree Celsius is 334 joules per gram. Our options are 100 grams, 40 grams, 50 grams, and 60 grams. This is a relatively simple question from calorimetry, that is from thermal physics. Let us now try to solve this question. For the sake of convenience, let us convert joules into calories. Specific heat of water, comma SW equals 4.2 divided by 4.2 equals 1 calorie per gram degree Celsius. Specific heat of ice, comma S ice equals 2.1 divided by 4.2 equals 0.5 calories per gram degree Celsius. And the latent heat of fusion of ice, comma L equals 334 divided by 4.2, which is approximately equal to 80 calories per gram. Now, the heat lost by water is Q equals MST, which equals 50 into 1 into 40 equals 2000 calories. Let the amount of ice present initially be x grams, the amount of heat gained by ice is Q equals MST plus ML, which equals x into 0.5 into 20 plus bracket starts x minus 20 into 80. Since equating heat gained equals heat lost, we get 10x plus 80x minus 1600 equals 2000, or 90x equals 3600, or x equals 40 grams. So our answer matches with option 2, and hence option 2 is the right answer. Our next question is, three charges, capital Q, plus small q, and plus small q, are placed at the vertices of an isosceles right-angled triangle, as shown in the figure. The net electrostatic energy of the system is zero if the value of capital Q is. Our choices are minus small q divided by 1 plus root 2, minus root 2 q divided by root 2 plus 1 plus small q, and minus 2 small q. Now this is a very simple question from electrostatic potential and potential energy. Let us try to solve this question. Let ABC represents the right angle triangle with right angle at B. If side AB equals side BC equals A, then side AC equals root 2 A. The total electrostatic potential energy of a system of charges is equal to the algebraic sum of the potential energy of all possible pair of charges. In the present case, since there are three charges, so it will constitute three pairs, one between plus Q and plus Q, another between plus Q and capital Q, and the other one again between plus Q and capital Q. So therefore, the potential energy will have three terms. Hence, potential energy U equals K small q square divided by A plus K into small q capital Q divided by A plus K small q capital Q divided by root 2 A equals 0. Or capital Q into 1 plus 1 by root 2 equals minus of small q, or capital Q equals minus of root 2 small q divided by 1 plus root 2. Wow, our answer matches with option 2, therefore option 2 is the right answer. Our next question is, an object is at a distance of 20 meters from a convex lens of focal length 0.3 meters. The lens forms an image of the object. If the object moves away from the lens with a speed of 5 meters per second, the speed and the direction of the motion of the image will be. Our choices are 1.16 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meters per second towards the lens, 2.26 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meters per second away from the lens, 3.22 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meters per second towards the lens, and 0.92 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meters per second away from the lens. This is an interesting problem from ray optics. Let us try to solve this question. Since the object is real, so U equals minus 20 meters. And for the convex lens, the focal length F equals plus 0.3 meters. Using the lens formula 1 by V minus 1 by U equals 1 by F, we get 1 by V equals 1 by F plus 1 by U, or 1 by V equals 10 divided by 3 minus 1 by 20, which on simplification gives me 1 by V equals 197 divided by 60 m^-1. Since in this question the object is in motion, the image will also be moving. So differentiating the lens formula 1 by V minus 1 by U equals 1 by F with respect to time, we get 1 by V square into dV by dt equals 1 by U square into du by dt, or dV by dt equals V square divided by U square into du by dt, or velocity of the image equals V by U whole square into velocity of the object, or velocity of the image equals 60 divided by 197 into 20 whole square into minus 5, which gives me the velocity of the image equals minus 1.16 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meters per second. That means the image will be moving at a speed of 1.16 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meters per second towards the lens. So our answer matches with option 1, and therefore option 1 is the right answer. In ray optics, please pay attention to the sign conventions, otherwise you will go wrong. I hope you enjoyed this question, and in case you have any difficulties, please write back to me in the comment box. Do not forget to comment, like, share and subscribe this channel, and visit us again for the next question. Till then, enjoy yourself.